Shannon and I were up in Missouri at a home we recently bought there. And we were doing some work on it. And she told me one morning she was going to get up early and watch the royal wedding. So she got up and she watched everything that took place before the royal wedding. And while she was doing that, I was changing a ceiling fan and the room the TV was on. So I happened to overhear all the commentary about the royal wedding and royal family, and I got to listen to the service. And there was a couple things that made me think about the service that was coming up, the marriage of Todd and Anna. One thing was, you know, I thought about most girls, a lot of girls, when they're little, they want to be a princess. Like, Anna wanted to be a princess, Tallulah. Like princess, girls dream of being a princess. And then as they get older, girls dream of being a bride. And, you know, that was Marvel's day, to be a princess and a bride. Today is Anna's day, to be a princess and a bride. The other thing that struck me about the ceremony was when the bishop, Michael Curry, got up to speak. I thought, that's a little unusual. I didn't expect that in the royal wedding. And he got up to speak, and as he spoke, the camera showed the royal family, and the royal family, I mean, it's like they didn't expect what he was saying. They didn't expect that type of message to take place during that service. But I thought it was a great message. And the message that he gave, if you didn't hear it, the message that he gave was about the power of love. And, you know, I was talking to Jane a few days ago, and talking to her about that message, the power of love. And I said, I want to say something about the power of love. And she mentioned something to me. And so I thought about it, and I thought, well, I want to read this. I think Anna and Todd would like this. It's by a great philosopher called Huey Lewis. The power of love is a curious thing. Makes one man weep, makes another man sing. Change a heart to a little white dove. More than feeling, that's the power of love. Tougher than diamonds, whips like cream. Stranger and harder than a bad girl's dream. Make a bad one good, make a wrong one right. The power of love will keep you home at night. Don't need money, don't need fame, don't need no credit card to ride that train. It's strong and it's sudden and it's cruel sometimes. But it might just save your life. That's the power of love. That's the power of love. The first time you feed it might make you sad. The next time you feel it might make you mad. But you'll be glad, baby, when you find that's the power of love that makes the world go round. Say that's all fair and love is fair. Yep, but that doesn't, but you don't care. But you know what to do when it gets hold of you. And with a little help from above, you feel the power of love. You feel the power of love, and you feel it. That's by Huey Lewis. So I thought about his message, Bishop Michael Curry's message, and really the point that he made in his message was that, you know, the essence of love comes from God. That God Himself is pure love. And God says to us in 1 Corinthians, God talks about what love is. He says love is patient and kind. Love doesn't envy or boast. Love is not arrogant or rude. It doesn't always insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It doesn't rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. And Jesus said, also in the New Testament, you know, he was to some people and he told them that everything in the Bible leading up to that point, you know, was talking about God's relationship with men and with the people of that time. And he said that all of the laws and all the prophets and everything that had come before, of all of that, they all hinge on two things. The two things that they hinge on is, first, that we love God with all our soul, all our heart, and all our mind. The second thing he says is, he says that love your neighbor as yourself. When he says neighbor, I don't think he was talking about your next door neighbor. I think he was talking about love each other the way you love yourself. And I think that that starts first with God, but then it starts with your husband. So that's the power of love. Okay, let's continue with the service with okay, now we'll exchange the vows. Todd, will you repeat after me? I, Todd, take the Anna to be my wedded wife. Take Anna to have and to hold. From this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Thank you. Anna, repeat after me. Anna, I take thee, Todd.
Anna, I take thee, Todd.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold. From this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poor,
for richer, for poor,
in sickness and health,
in sickness and health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
till death do us part,
till death do us part.
Okay. Please go ahead and read your vows.
So, I know that there's some of you out there who know about my dating experience that was long and extravagant before I met Anna. And some of you may not know why. And the reason for that was because of these two. Did you sit down? You sat down. There you go. He disappeared on me. Because of these two. There were lots of women who I probably could have had a relationship with. But as I continued dating them, they didn't measure up to who I probably would eventually want them and eventually could bring home to meet Jake and Julia. So when I met Anna on that October evening in Cherry Creek at that wine bar, and then the next week at the Mexican restaurant, how am I doing so far?
You're good.
Okay, good. And then we kept going on date after date, and you kept checking every box for me. I knew that eventually I would be able to bring you home to meet our kids, my kids. I knew I would never have to regret that decision. You have been incredible. When you keep telling me that on our first date that it was a wrong move on my part when I made that move to kiss you on our first date, the bottom line is you opened up to me your life and And since then, you have opened up an amazing home for me. You have opened up your life to your friends and your family. You have made a wonderful home for us. And best of all, you have opened up your life to your daughter, which has been extremely difficult for you in a lot of ways. So here we stand today on a new adventure that we're taking together. And I hope going forward I will make fewer mistakes. And I've learned so much from it. I've learned, hopefully, from the mistakes that I've made. And I will take the advice from my mom for the first time today.
Been my best friend and my mentor and my playmate and my confidant, but most importantly, you are the love of my life, and you have made all the things future. You make me happier than I could ever imagine, and more love than I ever thought possible. I wake up excited for the day ahead because you're in it, and when I hear you come through the back door after work, my heart still skips a beat knowing I get to be near you again. You make me a better mother, as our love is reflected in the way I now live my life. Tallulah and I are truly blessed to be a part of your family with Juliet and with Jake, which as of today becomes our life together as a family. I have a few little promises I would like to make to you. I promise to always ask before I bring home more animals. I promise never to steal your covers unless you're hogging them. I promise not to watch the next episode of a show we're binge watching together. And last but certainly not least, I promise not to spend all our money at Target. I love you.
Said, let's get these two married. Okay, if you'll repeat after me, I give you this ring as a daily reminder of my love for you. Todd? By the power of your love and commitment, and the power vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And I kiss your daughter.
Star Wars.